We have here the project with JCD, Facility Service and Building Maintenance in London. And JCD is the leading provider of facility solutions with 9,000 employees. 85% are temporarily contracted. The business is growing rapidly with 13.5% per year. And the fight for employees is getting tougher for all facility management companies. The expectations of our customers are still growing for new services, more flexibility, better trained people, hourly changing service demands. Today, our customer can contact for his request the facility coordinator or our call center. Many requests are handled by the facility coordinator and his team on site. Requests are related to facility repair work, electrical, HVAC and mechanical and landscape have been requested at the call center. We have in average 640 requests per day, and the trend is growing. We think we could sell more services if we would offer a way to make it for the customer easier to place his requests. The complications. JCD has a high fluctuation rate in temporary contracts. JCD has each month a high effort with acquisition, onboard and onboard process. The costs for the personal agency are increasing immense. In the fall and winter months, we need more craftsmen to repair the buildings or the properties. Short-term service requests of the customer cannot be released because of the lack of business processes and service staff. JCD want to sell 15% more flexible services to the customer. Solution. Develop a digital platform for the core business processes. We want to automate the automation of all manual business processes as a plan. The recruitment portal for new hires. And with the recruitment portal, we can build up a flex force consisting of retired professional, semi-professional craftsmen, handymen, and service staff who are motivated to increase their pension or income. Flexforce employees will be freelancers. They don't stay on our payroll, and we save onboard and onboard process. TCO savings. Internal job market for signed up service agents. Automation of incoming service requests. The benefits will be recruitment portal helps to recruit people much more flexible, offer a new flexible services for our customers, extend range of interested craftsmen and service staff, strengthen core competency with cloud-based process automation and automated online customer interaction, provide more agile services. Leading Praxis provides a taxonomy of 91 periodic enterprise elements. The taxonomy provides us a cross-industry innovation and is the basis for connecting a component to other elements within and across different enterprise layers. With the 91 meter objects, we can keep our focus on one area by breaking down a system into smaller manageable subsystems and combine them differently. Leading Praxis provides also a digital innovation transformation framework together with a lifecycle concept. On top, we see the swim lane concept, and also we see on the bottom the infinity loop that will show us that the process will never end. So when we have the project implemented, then we go in the phase of continuous improvement, govern and optimize continually, and then we go up new in the understand and analyze phase. Here we have the technology mapping of our new solution. We have the red blocks, the green blocks are already implemented, and we have to add now the red technical components. We have objectives, automate clouds to improve corporate service, cloud to improve resource management, and the critical success factors improve operational excellence. Here we have the digital technology mapping of 91 enterprise elements. We have a mapping of the solution components to the enterprise layers. This is a decomposition of the solution elements along the enterprise layers. On the Y coordinate, we have the enterprise layers, the business information and technology layer, with the sub layers, and value capability, service process, application data, platform, and industry. At the X coordinate, we have the technical components. The green ones are already implemented, and the red one we have to implement. And when you see, we have, for example, Azure Logic App. It's an application server. It's related to application information. And Azure Logging, for example, is a platform service. It's related to platform and technology. So we can see where our technical components are related in our enterprise layer. Here we have the solution technology anchoring with a primary domain model. We have, for example, we have the application service. It's an operating model with a digital opportunity, the digital workplace opportunity. We can see the result of the analysis of each technical component related with the domain model. Further, we identified the concrete opportunity of each technical component and domain model. Each technical component has one or more domain models and opportunities. Here we see the solution technology anchoring with the primary and secondary domain model. Each domain model can have one or more opportunities. And the bottom line, you can see that our domain models are related to a digital innovation or digital transformation. The revenue model, the value model, and the service model is related to the digital innovation. The cost model, performance model, operating model is related to the transformation model. And so that we can see our technical component or our technical components have a different impact to our project. For example, our Power BI has a domain model. It's a value model, and the opportunity is value governance. The secondary domain model is a revenue model with the opportunity of customer needs and wants. This is a transformation and innovation or innovation transformation process. Also effect. As we see, which kind of effect does have this technical component to our project? Which kind of benefits we will have through this technical component to our project? So it makes easier to see what is the impact or what is the benefit with this component in our project. Here we have the heat map. We have here the technical components which we have to add to our project, in our project, to reach our goals. We have the first and secondary domains with the specification, with the opportunities for each domain model. And at the end, we see the focus is a transformation, the innovation or transformation, or innovation and transformation focus. Here we have the product innovation canvas. The product innovation canvas gives us an overview about our new product with different scales. We have the scale of the customer, the product definition, and the delivery experience. This helps us to see which what is the impact for who is our ideal client, who is our stakeholder, what is the customer job, the success measures, and for example the purchase window. So we can see what is the promise, what is our promise, what is the benefit, and what is the, how is the pricing model, and like this. And at the end, we have the delivery experience with marketing, purchase process, and service and support model. Then we have the innovation transformation canvas. This shows us the innovation and transformation life cycle. The canvas describes what we are doing concrete for each, for the project in each different phase. The phase three, we can see which domain model are impacted and the related opportunities. Conclusion, road to success. We did already identify the missing components for the required technical solution with the digital technology mapping. Matching the technical solution model against the business requirement, solution technology anchoring, and identifying the impacting domain models and opportunities for the technologies with the heat map. Call to action, placement of the order, stakeholder kickoff meeting, and creating the first project plan. The second use case is the New York City Yellow Cab Taxi Corporation. This company is in New York and owns 142 taxis and is founded in 1978. In the beginning, the business was very successful, but during the last years, we have a strong impact with the rideshare service like Uber. In New York, we have more than 20 ridership services, and the business is getting more and more difficult. And we have the situation that the ridership trend is changing during the day. The ridership trend is impacted through the weather, the weekday, for holiday season, for issues with a subway, it's impacted from the flight plan of the airports and like this. So the problem is that the taxi driver is always behind the ridership trend. And this is a reason why we are losing money. We have resolution. The taxis will be equipped with IoT to provide the information, the current position, time pick up and drop off location with passenger, how long was the trip and the turnover. Our own taxis will provide the current waiting time at the airports. And if our taxi driver will a passenger who is looking for a taxi, he will send a post to the colleagues who are in the neighborhood. The internet will provide, that is one input. We get one input from the taxi to our, we want to, the goal is to implement a real-time analytics system to create a ridership trend that our taxi drivers know ahead how will we change the trend of our passengers. We get many information from the taxi, and we will get the other pool of information is the internet. The internet will provide all dynamic occurrences like the malfunctions of the subway, updated flight plans with delays, the program of theaters and big culture events, holiday season weather for the next 2 hours. And how many other taxis, Ubers, are currently in the same neighborhood from our own company, from the competitors. And an analyze and reporting service will calculate the average tip per mile driven for each neighborhood real time and provide early ridership trends for taxi drivers. Second step will be increasing the availability of taxi through reducing the maintenance time, and third step, food delivery service. Here we have the technology mapping of our new solution. The green one are already implemented. The red one, red boxes have to be installed. Also we have our objectives and critical success factors. Here we have the digital technology mapping of to the 91 enterprise elements. We have the mapping of the solution components with the enterprise layers. This is the decomposition of the solution elements along the enterprise layers. Here we can see the result of the analysis of each technical component related with the domain model. Further, we identified the concrete opportunity of each technical component and domain model, and each technical component has one or more domain models and opportunities. That can we see here. For example, we have here Azure Databricks is an application service. It's a domain. The domain is a writing model, and the opportunity is digital workplace opportunity. And the value model, second domain is a value model, and the opportunity is value opportunity. And it's related to application and information enterprise layer. And when we see here the digital information, digital transformation, operating is digital information, and the value model is digital innovation. So it's an innovation transformation use case. Here we have the concentrate of all technical components which one we have to add. And we can see the focus. We have one component with innovation transformation focus and two with transformation. Here we have the product innovation canvas. The product innovation canvas gives us an overview about our new product with different scales. Our ideal client, our company owns the nearly 150 taxis, and we sell each day our taxi to the taxi driver. The taxi driver pays us $100 per day that he gets our taxi, and we provide with our taxi the service. The service is that our taxi driver get for this money our taxi, and he get also a real-time ridership trend. And we have, because this is in the future our product for the taxi driver. Otherwise, we have the risk that he will leave our company, our service, and he will go then to Uber, because for Uber he has not to pay $100 per day to get a taxi. In America, in New York, is the situation so that we have to pay minimum $300,000 for a taxi license. The taxi license is related to the car and not to the driver. So we have to buy for each taxi a taxi license, and the price is minimum around $250,000 actually. So that's the reason that many taxi drivers cannot pay this money. So they go to a taxi company and they rent each day a taxi for $100. The stakeholder is the CEO of a yellow taxi cab, and the customer job is to be ahead of the ridership trend and provide a reliable and trusted service. Increase the turnover and revenues, increase the customer satisfaction, that is our success measures. And our purchase window is after a successful test phase with 5 taxis. Then we have a product definition. The promises real-time event-driven hotspot identification and fleet routing. Benefit higher utilization and more revenues. The pricing model is given through the city, New York. And the delivery experiences are digital solution that integrate into the current operating model, providing enhanced efficiency and productivity. And marketing is catch up more profitable rides be ahead of the ridership trend. Our innovation transformation canvas shows us the innovation transformation lifecycle and describes what we are doing concrete for each for our project in each phase. And our conclusion is road to success. What did we already identifying the missing components for the required technical solution, matching the technical solution model against the business requirements, and identifying the impacting domain models and opportunities of the technologies. Call to action, placement of the order, stakeholder kickoff meeting, and creating a first project plan. Thank you very much.